Sesame Street, show 65 in color.
Here we go. Lance and Kevin and I are just having a little game of catch here. Okay, here comes my Sesame Street bounce, Lance. You know, it's kind of a nice thing to have friends to play with.
Hey, Ernie. What's the matter? It's a sunny day on Sesame Street. What's the matter with you?
Well, I don't know. I'm just kind of bored, I
You're
guess.
You're bored?
Know? Yeah, because Bert's over reading
yeah,
a book. And
right.
Everybody else is busy. And
yeah.
Well, I'm just kind of sitting here.
Ernie, I got the answer for you.
What's that?
You need a friend.
Well, yeah, maybe.
Yeah, you need a friend.
Well, but who should I make friends with?
Fear not. How about this guy?
Me?
Uh-huh.
Who's that?
That's an anything.
Oh, it's an anything, huh?
It's an anything. His name is Harvey Anything.
Oh, old Harv's got kind of a blank look to him, don't you think?
Oh, yeah, but we can take care of that.
Sure.
How?
Right, because we'll just make him into something. What would you like to be made into?
A ham sandwich.
With lettuce and tomato?
Hold a tomato.
I've never had a friend who was a ham sandwich.
I was only kidding.
He was only kidding.
Oh, were you
kidding.
Really?
He's yeah, banana cream else. Pie I'd like to be.
Oh, no, no, you're not.
No,
you're
you can't be a banana cream pie. You got to be something, Harvey.
Okay, let's see. Yeah,
okay, cool it now. Let's get some eyes.
Putting eyes on him.
Okay,
huh?
He's got eyes now, right? What do you feel like, Harvey?
Oh, I feel like a poem is coming on.
You think maybe
poem.
He might be a poet?
A poem.
Yeah.
All right, well, let's go. Give him a little poet nose.
Hey, good idea. Okay.
Like a poet nose?
A poet's nose. Best.
Now you can smell things like roses, which are red.
Roses.
Hey, why don't you put some hair on him, Gordon?
Poet hair.
Give him some hair.
Poet hair.
Sure.
Look at that. Look at that.
Oh, yes.
Now that's the kind of poet hair we like.
Oh, yes. A poem. It's coming.
Hey, that's great. Hey, horrible buddy. How are you, my friend?
Please. I'm trying to think of a poem.
Oh, well, Listen, just go right ahead. I mean, don't let me interrupt you. You know, you just think up your poem, and I'll just sit here, and maybe I'll help you. How about that? Can I help you do the poem?
You could help by trying to be a bit more quiet.
Well,
poem.
What are you thinking of? Maybe I can help.
Well, I'm thinking of a rhyme for June.
Oh, rhyme for June.
Yes.
Hey, that's easy. How about moon? Or spoon? Or balloon, maybe? Or
about buffoon.
Buffoon. That's
yes,
a good one too.
Buffoon.
Or soon.
Could you
that's
please,
another one.
Could you please try not to help me? I'm trying to think of a poem myself.
Oh well. Sure.
June.
Hey, Gordon.
Yeah.
June.
What's the matter?
You know, it's kind of hard to make friends with somebody if you can't even talk to them.
It's not your kind of cat. Huh?
No, I don't
okay.
think so.
Harvey.
Yes.
Harvey, come over here. For
I have a
minute.
Poem. I have a
I
poem.
I know you have a poem, but just
roses are red.
You can't smile at
violets
smell it anymore.
Violets are purple.
You can't see it any longer. Violets are purple?
Yes.
What rhymes with
the rest
purple?
Of
in June.
In June?
I wanted to say June somewhere.
Take your hair off here.
I think he was a bad poet anyway.
Yeah, he wasn't very good.
No.
Yeah. Okay.
What now?
We'll change you. If we just put your eyes right here.
Yeah, those are different eyes this time.
They're different eyes. Yeah. Yes, they're upside down.
No, they're the same. They're two eyes.
Oh, yeah?
Okay.
Yeah.
And your nose.
Yeah, don't forget the,
what are those, eyebrows?
Yes, you're right, Ernie. They're eyebrows. Yeah.
Yeah.
How'd you know that?
Oh, I could tell.
You could tell?
Yeah.
Because they're going over the eyes, huh? Okay. There you go.
You know, though, Gordon, he looks kind of sad now.
Yeah.
Hello, friend. Oh, gee, what did I say?
You said, hello, friend.
Well, sure I did.
Well, see, if you're my friend and you're saying hello, then we're probably going to have a wonderful time today.
Well, what's so sad about that?
You see, after we've had a wonderful time, I'll have to say goodbye and go home for dinner. I hate goodbyes.
Maybe we could see each other again tomorrow, huh?
But then tomorrow we'll have to say goodbye again.
Oh, okay. Gordon, I can't have a friend who's this sad. No, it would never work out, I can tell.
He's getting to me, too.
You're going to have to change him.
Yeah, change her quick. Easy. Take it easy.
I'm feeling better.
Are you feeling better?
I'm feeling better.
All right. Let's see if we can't...
I'm feeling a little bit...
You're changing his eyebrows.
Yeah, change his eyebrows. That usually does it.
Hey, what's going on? Hey!
Hey, you know, now he doesn't look so sad.
No.
Now he looks sort of mad.
Hey! Oh, boy, does that make me mad!
Well, what does?
I really get mad when someone says I look like I'm mad.
Well, I'm sorry.
Oh, that makes me mad, too. Boy, it really makes me mad when someone says he's sorry. What's your name, fella? What's your name? Tell me.
My name is...
I bet it's Ernie, right?
It's Ernie, yes.
I hate Ernie!
Oh,
what a terrible name.
Well, listen.
That really makes me mad, too. How do you get off?
Excuse me, you guys named
Ernie.
Gordon, listen. I don't think he's my kind of fellow.
No, I don't think...
I can't have him as a friend. Don't you think you can make some sort of guy who's, you know, sort of more like me?
More like you?
Yeah. More like you, huh?
Yeah. All right. Harvey!
What?
Harvey, come here.
What?
Bend down.
He's different already.
Yeah.
I'm sorry about that.
Oh, that's all right.
I don't know what happened.
That's all right. Give you a little Ernie
type hair.
That's
good looking hair.
You like that, Ernie?
Yeah. Ooh. It's the same color as mine.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Ooh.
He doesn't seem to be hearing too well either, you know.
No.
Can you hear anything?
What? What'd he say?
Don't worry.
He said, can you hear anything?
What?
Can you hear anything? Okay.
Oh, he's got an ear now.
He's got an ear.
What?
Yeah. You got another one?
See, he has to listen on this side, too.
Oh, I hear you.
Your other ear. Your other ear.
Yeah.
Other ear. But you come here.
Yeah.
All right. Good. That's two ears. How's the other one?
Okay.
Good. Solid.
Okay.
Yeah,
right.
That looks nice.
Good. Now he's looking more and more like you, Ernie.
Change my eyes a little bit, just a little bit.
Well, change your eyes a little bit?
Just a little bit, yeah. Just a little bit.
Just a little bit, and they'll become Ernie eyes.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
You like that?
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah, my nose.
How about a nose?
Your nose?
Give him a nose.
Oh, yeah. Ernie nose.
Yeah.
Is that in there really good? Make sure it's a good Ernie nose.
That's looking good, Ernie. That's looking good.
Okay.
Hey, gee, Ernie, old pal, old buddy, how'd you like to come over to my place and look at my toy box? Wow, Harvey, old fella, you know, that's a great idea. I'd like to do that. Attaboy, Ernie, old guy. You know, I've got a stuffed doggy, and I got a yo-yo, and a rubber ducky. A rubber ducky? You have a rubber ducky? I have a rubber ducky, too. You know, that's my very favorite toy of all. Hey, what else? What other kind of toys do you have? Well, you know, we could play, tic-tac-toe?
Hey, I think tic-tac-toe
is my very favorite game.
Hi, I'm a seal. Seal begins with a letter S. Can you say S? Try it. S. Oh, very good. Now I want you to listen to a little story. There are a lot of words in it that begin with a letter S. Listen for them. Six silly sailors came skating down our street. They passed a smiling snowman wearing sneakers on his feet. Then they spied a schoolyard. So they took turns on the slide. And all played on the seesaw. Three sailors on each side. Hey, great! Isn't S a swinging letter, though? Oh, you bet it is. Well, see you later. I'm gonna go have a sandwich. Another nifty S word?
What's that?
That's a something. Something starts with S.
That's an S.
And that's a snake.
And snake starts with S.
I am a snake. My name is Sam.
And Sam starts with S.
Looky there, the snake is smiling.
Smiling starts with S.
Sam the snake sees several skunks.
Skunks start with S.
I'm a skunk. My name is Sissy.
Sissy starts with S.
Sometimes skunks are sort of smelly.
Smelly starts with S.
Sam and Sissy see a seesaw.
Seesaw starts with S.
Sam and Sissy saw a seesaw.
Saw starts with S.
Sam and Sissy build a slide.
Slide starts with S.
Sam and Sissy see some soldiers.
Soldiers start with S. I am a soldier. My name is Sanford.
Sanford starts with S.
The other soldiers make a snowman.
Snowman starts with S.
I am a snowman. My name's Hubert.
Hubert? That doesn't start with S.
Now, Susan and I are going to sing a little song about some of the parts of our faces. Now, you remember that a face starts, right about at the bottom of your chin, mm-hmm. Right?
Yeah.
And it stops right about where your hair begins. Now, we're going to sing a song about some of the things in between, and you see if you can guess what we're talking about.
Okay, listen to each
Hey, why don't you go first?
Okay. Let's see. Oh, right in the middle of my face, right in a very special place, is a thing that helps me sneeze and breathe as easy as I please. It helps me smell a pretty rose. And it's called a nose. Yes, I got a nose. I got a nose, oh yes I do. And so do you.
And so do I.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I'd say
above
that.
My nose, I am sure you will agree, there are two things that help me see. I use them when I look at you, and you use yours to see me too. They help see birds and trees and skies, and they're called eyes. Yes, I've got two eyes. I've got two eyes, oh yes I do, and so do you.
I've got two eyes.
You've got two eyes. Hey, let's do one together.
All right.
Right up above my chin, there is a thing I put food in. It helps me talk, it helps me chew, and then it helps me smile at you. From east to west and north to south, everybody's got a mouth. Yes, I got a mouth. I've got a mouth, oh yes I do. And so do you.
Two hats.
One, two.
Two
blue butterfly.
One, two.
Two chocolate cream pies.
Lance, how'd you like to offer this gerbil a peanut? Go ahead. On your own. Oops. Oh, he'll find it. He's gone away. But the surprise of the week. More gerbils. You like that? Now, they look a lot like rats. As a matter of fact, they're from the same family as rats and mice. And it's called the rodent family. So, Lance, if you should just happen to see an animal that looks like a gerbil, looks like one of these, inside or outside, don't pet him, okay? Because it may not be a gerbil. Gerbil's relatively harmless. Comes from deserts in Africa and Asia and southern Russia are also found. I'll throw another peanut in there, see what happens. They eat seeds and grasses and roots of some vegetables. They have a carrot in there now. They make good pets. That's why that wheel was in there that I took out. I'm gonna try to put it back in. Just see what happens. Come here. Come here, gerbil. Get up in there. See what happens? Well, you can't see him do too many things right now. Oh, there he goes. Now, see, right now we're just looking at this on Sesame Street, Lance. And with our own eyes, we're seeing what they're doing as best we can. But if we were looking at it on film with a lot of camera tricks, then we'd be able to see animals like gerbils do all kinds of strange things and would slow them down and back them up in different shots. You know what I mean? You understand? You sure? You don't? You do? All right, well, watch this and you'll see.
What if you were magic and could make things stop just by telling them to, or make them go backwards? Go backwards! Stop! Then you could see what things look like when they're moving. Go forward! Stop! Well, film is magic, and this is a film, so you can be magic for 3 minutes, like this. Go slow, water fountain!
Fly backwards.
bags.
Sure. My backwards! Right up and stop! Stop! Backwards!
E, E, see me, eating a peach, sitting on my eagle, chasing a beagle, to the queen on her knee, under a tree, by the sea. She was looking for her Easter egg. Having a dream about eating ice cream in the land of steam. When a baby seal tickled her heel, she let out a squeal. And woke from her dream in time to see the eagle and me flying away with the Easter egg over the evening sea.
To get that cookie?
From the cookie cabinet.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's my cookie, Ernie.
It is?
Yep. Hmm. You ding-a-ling, you know it's mine.
Well, gee, Bert, it came from the cookie cabinet, you know. Everything in the cookie cabinet's always all mixed up, Bert.
Not anymore.
No, Bert?
No. Because I went and I bought myself a whole new cabinet full of cookies.
Oh, you mean this one over here, Bert?
That's right. Oh, see there?
Look at that.
Yeah. And just so nobody gets mixed up, I had him put a big B for Bert on it. See?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, B is the first letter in Bert. That's my name, Ernie, Bert.
Right.
Now, everything with a B for Bert on it is mine. Got that?
Yeah, I get it, Bert.
Okay, good.
Everything with a B for Bert on it is yours, right?
Is mine, everything.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Hey, wait a minute.
What?
Where are you going?
I was just going to get some cookies.
Those are my cookies.
Well, now, wait a minute, Bert. Everything with a B for Bert on it is yours, right?
Right.
So everything with an E for Ernie on it is mine, right?
I suppose so.
Yeah, okay.
Wow.
E for Ernie. Hey, you want a cookie, Bert?
No, I'm not hungry anymore.
One, two, three, four, five, six, 7, 8, 9 eggs and 1 cookie, 10 eggs and 1 cookie, 11 eggs and 1 cookie.
This weird story of Wanda the Witch is brought to you courtesy of the letter W.
Wanda the Witch lived somewhere west of Washington. Around her waist, instead of a belt, she wore a worm. Wanda had a pet weasel.
I'm a weasel.
And on her head, a wiry wig. On Wednesday, in the middle of winter, Wanda walked to the well to get water to wash her wig. But the wheel on the well was worn, and Wanda grew weary. So she waved her wand, and her washtub filled with warm water. But just as Wanda was about to drop her wig into the warm water, a wild wind whipped the wig from her hand and blew it away forever. Which taught Wanda this lesson. Witches who wash their wigs on windy winter Wednesdays are wacky.
This witch story was brought to you courtesy of the letter W.
Hey, Jim! Hey, Jim!
What is it, buddy?
I got a surprise for you, Jim.
Oh, boy. A surprise for me? Oh, what is it?
I can't tell you what it is. If I told you what it was, it wouldn't be a surprise, Jim.
I never thought of that.
Hey, Jim, want me to unwrap it?
Why don't you unwrap it?
Hey, that's a good idea, Jim. Right. I'll unwrap it. You get great ideas, Jim. Here we go! It's a picture of me.
Oh, boy. A picture of you? Ah, that's great. Our little room could sure use some brightening up.
Jim, you wouldn't believe it. I was walking down the street, minding my own business, you know, walking along, and all of a sudden I walked by the department store, and I just happened to look in the window, and there's this terrific picture of me. I couldn't pass it up. I said, I'll just take that, go in and buy it, and take it home and give it to Jim for a present.
Well, I think that's great. Let me take a look.
All right.
Wait a minute. There's something wrong here.
What? What's wrong?
This isn't a picture of you.
Well, it sure looks like me.
This is a picture of me.
Wait a minute. Let me see.
Hold everything. I didn't notice this before. This is a picture of both of us.
Oh, I'm sorry, Jim. Boy, just wait till I get a hold of the guy that sold me that picture.
Hold it, buddy. I think this is even better. A picture of both of us. Buddy and Jim, two friends, together. Right here in the picture.
That's a nice picture, Jim.
Oh, it sure is.
Buddy and Jim. Jim, I'm sure glad you liked the picture. I'll see you later.
So long, buddy. And thanks again for buying this great picture of Buddy and Jim. Two friends. Hey, buddy.
Hey, come on, Ernie. Dinner's ready.
Okay, Bert, I'll be right along. Okay. Right after I have a couple of these cookies.
Hey, no, you ding-a-ling. No, you don't eat cookies before dinner. You eat them after dinner. They might spoil your appetite.
Right, Bert.
Okay.
I'll be right along, right after I have a couple of these cookies.
Good. Hey, no, wait a minute now. Hey, Ernie, don't you know the difference between before and after?
Oh, sure, Bert. Yeah, I'm not so sure.
Yeah. Okay, well, now listen carefully, and I'll try and explain it to you, all right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now, you see, before you can have those cookies, you have to lift that cover.
Uh-huh.
Right. Now, after the cover is lifted, then you can have the cookies.
Right.
Right. Now you understand?
Well, let me see now. Make sure I understand it. Now, before I can have a cookie,
yeah,
I have to lift the cover.
Right.
Now, after I lift the cover, then I can have a cookie,
right? Okay, now let's go to dinner, okay?
Oh, no. I'm not sure. I'm not sure that I got it absolutely straight. Now, see if this is right.
Yeah.
Now, before I can have a cookie,
yeah,
I have to lift the cover.
Right.
Now, then, after I lift the cover,
yeah,
then I can have a cookie.
Okay, right. Now you know it, so let's go.
One more time. One more time, just to make sure, absolutely certain I got it right.
Okay? All right.
Now, before I can have a cookie, I have to lift the cover.
Lift the cover.
After the cover is lifted, then I can have the fourth cookie.
Right. Okay, now you understand, so let's go and eat, all right?
Eat?
Yeah.
Gee, Bert, I'm not hungry now. You want a cookie, Bert?
Hey, Sarah, who do you think made Ernie's cookies anyway? You think the fireman made them?
No.
What about the doctor? You think the doctor made Ernie's cookies? Who makes cookies?
The baker.
The baker made them, yeah. Do you see anything else on the counter that maybe the baker made?
The bread.
The bread.
And the crackers.
The crackers.
And the cake.
And the cake were all made by the baker. Mm-hmm. You know, if he makes cookies and bread, and crackers and cake, that baker's a very busy person.
My name is Shep. That's me with my mommy going into the bakery around the corner. Mommy wanted to get an apple cream pie for dinner.
Hey, could I have one of each of these fruit tarts and
pony recipes? Sal, the baker, came out with some cookies, and I wondered what it would be like to be a baker. I thought about it real, real hard, and suddenly, I was a baker.
You ready to go to work?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Sal took me into the back where they make the pies, and I met Donato, one of the other bakers, and they showed me how to make an apple cream pie.
That's the thing, we gotta do the pop and margarine.
Donato took some butter, and we weighed it and put it in a big bowl. Then he took some flour and we weighed that and put it in the bowl. After he put some sugar and other things in, he broke a whole bunch of eggs into another bowl. Then he started mixing them up, like Mommy does when she makes scrambled eggs. When everything was ready, Donato wheeled the bin over to a machine. When he turned it on, the machine started mixing everything together. Then he gave me the eggs to pour in. That was fun, watching them get mixed up with the other things.
How much did that have to go for?
5 minutes.
When it was finished being mixed, Donato said it was called dough. While we were taking the dough out of the bowl and patting it flat, Sal was cooking a whole bunch of apples so they would be all soft and juicy for the pie. When the apples were ready, Sal took the dough that Donato and I had made and started making the pie.
Put on the table.
He took a big handful of dough and rolled it out flat with the rolling pin. Then he took a little pin and rolled the dough into it.
Now we get the apple.
And filled it all up with apples. Then it was ready to be baked in the oven. So the dough would turn into pie crust and the apples would taste even better. After we took the hot pie out of the oven, Sal took a funny looking bag and filled it with whipped cream. Hole in one end, and Sal squeezed the whipped cream onto the top of the pie. Now it was finished, and boy, did it look good. We put it in a box and took it out to Mommy. And suddenly, I bet Mommy never knew I helped bake that pie.
Hello, Gordon.
Hi.
Hi.
Hey, you know, this is one of our anything people. They can be anything they want. It's a whole family of them.
Yeah, hello.
What do you want to be today?
I want to be a little girl.
You want to be a little girl?
Can you give me some pretty eyes?
Little girl
eyes?
Yes. Yeah. What's that? Little girl eyes. Hair of them.
Oh, that's
that?
Nice. Do you have some hair for me?
Little girl hair,
pretty
right?
Pretty blonde hair.
You want pretty blonde hair?
Yes.
Okay. Have what you like. Now you're a little girl.
That's nice. Thank you. Hey, how about me?
What about you?
I want to be a little boy.
You want to be a little boy?
Yeah, yeah. Hmm. Some eyes. Boy
little
eyes.
Boy eyes?
Yeah. He's my brother.
He is your brother?
Uh-huh.
Really?
Yeah.
How do you know?
Oh, I'm a brother, all right.
You can tell.
Yeah. Yes, he is.
Wait, I've got one more thing for you.
What the?
Little boy eyebrows.
Oh, yeah.
Strong, sturdy eyebrows.
Oh, that looks good. Yeah,
like
thank you.
That?
Yeah.
And can I help you?
Why, yes. Hello, Gordon.
Hello. Well, what would you like to be?
Well, I think today I'd like to try on Mother.
Hello, Mother. Hello,
Mom. I want to be a mother?
Yeah, I want to be the mother.
And you recognize her already. She doesn't even have her mother eyes on yet. Or her mother nose. There's her mother nose.
Mm-hmm.
How's that look?
That feels good.
Looks pretty good? Let's get it in good.
Mm. Fine nose.
Okay, and your mother eyes. These are your mother eyes. Look at that.
They're pretty.
You like that?
Yeah. Thank you, dear.
What do you need? You want a bald-headed mother?
No, I'd prefer to have something stylish and...
Something chic.
Yeah, yeah.
You like that?
Yeah.
Okay. That's terrific.
Oh, thank you, Gordon.
Hi, family.
Dad. I bet that's Dad, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Hello, Dad.
Let me check with the family. Is this their father?
Yeah.
You can tell.
Yeah, that's Bill.
Yep. Today I'll be a father.
Today you'll be a father.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You need a father nose, then.
Right.
Here's a father nose. Got that?
Thank you.
You could use father eyes.
Please.
Two of them.
Mm-hmm.
Father eyes and father nose.
Oh, there. Very good. How about a mustache?
Father mustache.
Yes.
Oh,
okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Look at that. There's a good father mustache. Little father hair?
A little bit, yes.
Could go for that. I only have a little bit. You're getting old, father.
Oh, look, he looks distinguished that
does
way.
Does he? I'm sorry.
Yeah,
I didn't mean to offend.
How about me?
Well, who are you?
I'm going to be the uncle.
You're going to be the uncle?
Yeah, today he'll be the uncle.
Well, let me check with the family. Is it all right?
Yeah, it's okay.
We should also have an uncle.
Sure, right.
Uncle. Oops. Here's an uncle nose.
All right.
Now, family, what do you think? Look good?
Yeah.
Yeah, that'll do.
Yeah, that's pretty
gorgeous.
Good.
Okay. Uncle eyes.
Okay.
Here they are. Good?
Fine.
Yeah, he needs a mustache.
You think so?
Yeah.
Well, okay, your husband already has one.
Men look better with a mustache.
Yeah, I always love a man with a mustache.
Really?
Right.
Glad to know that. Now.
Right.
Some hair.
A little bit, please.
And you're all set. Consider yourself at home.
Okay.
Consider yourself part of the family.
Why not?
Right.
I've taken to you so strong.
Yeah?
It's clear we're... going to get along.
Consider yourself well in. Consider yourself part of the furniture.
There isn't a lot to spare. Who cares what ever we got we share.
If it's your chance to be, we should see some harder days. Empty lot of days. Why grouse?
Always a chance we'll meet somebody to foot the bill.
Drinks are on my house.
Soft drinks.
Consider yourself our mate. We don't want to have no fuss. For after some consideration, we can state, consider yourself one of us.
Consider yourself at home.
Consider yourself one of the family.
I've taken to you so strong.
It's clear that we're going to get along.
Consider yourself well in. Consider yourself part of the furniture.
There isn't a lot to spare.
Who cares what ever we got to share?
Nobody tries to be la-di-da and uppity. There's a cup of tea for all.
Only it's wise to be handy with the rolling pin when the landlord comes to call.
Everybody,
consider yourself our mate. We don't want to have no fuss. For after some consideration, we can stay. Consider yourself one of us.
It's time to play.
Oh, now let's look at this board over here. One of these things goes with the other. See if you can guess which one. Guess which thing belongs with the others. Do it before my song is done. Okay, let's look and see what we have here today. Now, we have a stick man, a stick man, a stick man. We have another stick man, a stick man, a stick man, and a stick man. But why does one of these belong over here? Can you figure out why? Do you think you know? Well, we'll see. Which of these things goes with the other? Do you think that this one might? If you guess that this thing goes with the others, then you're absolutely right. Okay, let's put him right over here where he belongs, and then we'll decide why he belongs on this side of the board. You see, we have stickmen on both boards, but these four stickmen are big, and these one, two, three. These three stickmen are little, so that's the only difference. These are big, and those are little, okay? Let's try another one. Okay. Are you looking at each one carefully? Here are some things that belong together. Here are some things that are kind of the same. Here are some things that belong together. Now it's time to play our game. Okay, let's look at this side over here. One of these things belongs with the other. See if you can guess which one. Guess which thing belongs with the other. Do it before my song is done. Oh, let's look at each shape and tell what it is. Now, this is a circle, a square, a triangle. A rectangle, a triangle, a square, and a circle. Now be careful, really look and figure out which one belongs over here. Do you think you know? Okay. Which of these things goes with the other? Do you think that this one might? If you guess that this thing goes with the others, then you're absolutely right. All right, let's put this rectangle right over here. Now, you might say, well, you said, Susan, that this was a triangle, and you said that that was a triangle, and you said this was a square, and that was a square. So why did you put the rectangle over here? It's not the shape, it's the size. You see, these are all the same size. These are little. Let's put this one up here a little better. Now, you see, these are little, and these three over here are big, so these are little and they belong together, and these are big and they belong together. Did you get that?
Mm-hmm. Hey.
Hey.
Hey. Yeah? Hey, Mac.
Yeah?
Hey, I wonder if you could help me.
Can I help you? Oh, yes, sir. I would be happy to. Anytime I can help anybody, you just call on old Ernie, old buddy. You just call on me. What can I do for you?
Well, yeah? See, I'm supposed to make this delivery,
yeah?
And I guess I'm lost.
Oh, no, you're not lost.
No?
No, no. I know exactly where you are.
Oh, where am I?
Right here.
I think I'll go somewhere else and...
Oh, no, wait a second. Come back here. Now that I've found you, what can I do to help you?
Oh, well, you see, I got this package to deliver to this lady, and I don't know where she lives.
Oh, wow, you've come to the right man. Because,
yeah?
You see, I know everybody in the whole neighborhood.
Oh, good.
Now, what's this lady's name?
Oh, her name, yeah. It's, It says it's Marianne. No, this last name I can't pronounce. I'll spell it.
Okay.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
That's her name?
Yeah.
Let's see. Let me think about it. What was that name again?
It's Marianne. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, listen, is that Miss Marianne? A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z? Or Mrs. Marianne, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z?
Let me check. It's Mrs. It's Mrs. Marianne. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
Oh, yeah, yeah, sure. I remember her. Yeah, she lives just a couple blocks down, you know?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, she lives right upstairs from Harold 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
That's his name? One, Harold 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10?
Yeah, yeah, that's right. You see, they're both school teachers. You see, Marianne, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z,
yeah,
teaches spelling.
Teaches spelling. Hey, wait a minute. Hey, hey. Marianne, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z, teaches spelling?
Yep.
Hey, hey. Then Harold, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 is a school teacher, too?
That's right.
I bet I can guess what he teaches.
Okay.
If Marianne, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z teaches spelling, I bet old Harold 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 teaches arithmetic.
Nope, nope. He's a music teacher.
A music teacher?
Yeah, he teaches a lot of great musical numbers.
I gotta deliver this package.
Yeah, yeah, you do that. It's important.
How do you know?
It's from me.
Figures.
Have you ever seen a really big machine? Well, there are great big machines that help build roads and bridges and buildings. There are big machines that do almost anything.
Aren't these cute?
Yeah.
They're little baby chicks, right?
Yeah.
Did you ever have a baby chicken on your head?
No.
You do now.
Whoa.
These are called Silver Cross baby chicks. You know about how old they are, Les, Sarah?
No.
Take a guess.
2 years old.
2 years old? No, much, much younger than that.
Why?
No, much younger. They're 3 days old. These little baby chicks are only 3 days old.
They're big for that.
They are big, aren't they? And they can eat all by themselves and drink water. They put their head in the water, and then they have to tilt it way back. See that one eating, drinking now?
Yeah.
Has to tilt his head way back so the water will go right down his throat. See? They make kind of a nice little peeping sound, don't they?
Yeah.
Did you ever wonder how they get outside of the egg
no.
that they're hatched in?
No.
What if they have something very special to help them get outside? You know what it is?
Yeah.
Do you? What is it?
A special tooth.
A special tooth, right. It's a little egg tooth, right?
Yeah.
And that helps them peck their way out of the eggshell. And then what happens after they get outside of the egg? What happens to that little special tooth?
It falls out.
It falls right off, right. Hey, you're pretty smart. Did your teacher tell you that?
They're hard to pick up, too.
They are. They're nice and furry now, but after a while they'll get their feathers, right. They kind of fly and... They do.
To keep them
nice and warm, right?
Yeah.
They like to eat the chicken feed. Good. Say hello. Would you believe that it's time to say goodbye already?
No.
You wouldn't believe it? Well, it is. Why don't you say goodbye?
Bye.
Say goodbye. We'll be back, though, and you come back, too, okay? Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters E, S, and W, and by the numbers 2 and 3. Sesame Street is a production of The Children's Television Workshop.
This is NET, the Public Television Network.